Hey there. You know, we're always told that rising prices are a bad thing and more jobs are a good thing. Simple enough, right? But what if I told you there's a hidden and kind of controversial link between the two? That in the short term, the very thing that makes your groceries more expensive might also be helping to create jobs. So let's dig in and unpack this surprising connection.
It sounds completely backward, doesn't it? I mean, how can inflation, the thing that shrinks our spending power, possibly lead to a healthier job market? Well, that's exactly the puzzle we're going to solve today. We're going to follow the economic chain reaction, step by step, to see how this whole thing actually works.
So, where does this all begin? You see, this whole economic story, it kicks off with just one single, really powerful decision. It's the catalyst, you know, the spark that sets everything off. A government just deciding to open up its wallet and spend. And this isn't just some abstract theory. I mean, think about it in the real world, right? We're talking about building new highways or maybe investing in green energy, expanding public services, that kind of stuff. So when the government decides to boost its spending, it's basically injecting a huge amount of cash right into the economy. And that is the very first domino to fall.
Okay, so that money doesn't just vanish into thin air. Nope, it creates these ripples all across the economy. And the first big effect? Well, things start to heat up.
The logic here is actually pretty simple when you break it down. So first, the government spends the money. That cash flows to companies and their employees who, you know, now have more money to spend themselves. This big surge in spending is what economists call a rise in aggregate demand. Basically, it just means everyone suddenly wants to buy more stuff. But, and this is the catch, the amount of stuff available to buy hasn't changed. So what happens when you have more money chasing the exact same amount of things? Yep, you guessed it. Prices have to go up.
All right, so prices are going up. And this is where the story starts to get really personal. We're moving away from the big picture economy and zooming right in on the reality of your paycheck and the squeeze that's about to happen. So here's the fundamental problem for any worker. Your salary, what economists call your nominal wage, is usually fixed, at least in the short term, right? You're getting paid the same this month as you did last month, but suddenly the price of everything, from gas to groceries, has shot up. The number on your paycheck looks exactly the same, but what you can actually buy with it? Yeah, that has definitely shrunk.
And this brings us to a really crucial idea, the real wage. This isn't about the number printed on your check. It's all about your actual purchasing power. So when prices go up, but that number on your paycheck stays the same, your real wage goes down. It's like, even though no one's officially cut your salary, you're actually getting poorer in terms of what you can afford day to day.
Okay, but here comes the twist. Because while a falling real wage is obviously bad news for workers, it looks totally different from the other side of the desk. For businesses, this whole situation, it actually creates a pretty unexpected opportunity.
Yeah, this quote just nails the business perspective. Because think about it. While your paycheck feels smaller to you, for an employer, the actual cost of your labor has just gone down in real terms. They're still paying you the same number of dollars, but the value of those dollars has dropped compared to the price of whatever it is they're selling. And all of a sudden, hiring new people starts to look like a really, really good deal. And this sets off a whole new chain reaction. You see, because labor is now relatively cheaper, businesses have this huge incentive to hire more people. And with more employees on board, what can they do? They can produce more goods, more services. This bump in production means the total economic output of the whole country starts to grow. And the final piece of the puzzle? It's simple, but it's powerful. When the economy is producing more stuff, well, it needs more people to do the work. More hiring means fewer people are out there looking for jobs. And just like that, the unemployment rate falls. We've literally just traced the entire path from rising prices all the way to falling unemployment.
Okay, so now let's put all these pieces together and see how economists actually visualize this whole process. It turns out a simple graph can make this entire relationship crystal clear.
All right, so on our graph, we're tracking two key things. On the vertical axis, we've got the overall price level, and on the horizontal, we have the national output, basically how much stuff the whole country is making. And before any of this started, the economy was just sitting in a nice, stable balance, which we're going to call point A. Now, remember that government spending spree we talked about? Well, that action is what causes the entire aggregate demand curve to shift over to the right. This shift is basically a picture of the economy heating up. It means that no matter what the price is, people are now trying to buy more stuff than they were before. So the economy isn't stable at point A anymore. It's on the move. So where does the economy end up? It settles at a new equilibrium, a new balancing point that we'll call point B. And just look at what's happened. If you compare it to where we started, point B shows both a higher overall price level and a higher national output. This graph perfectly tells our story. The whole chain reaction ends with higher prices and more economic output, which, of course, means more jobs. So let's just do a quick recap of the entire journey, okay? It all kicks off with a boost in government spending, which leads to inflation. That inflation then puts a squeeze on workers' real wages. That, in turn, makes it cheaper for businesses to hire. So companies respond by hiring more people, which boosts the national output and, at the end of the day, lowers unemployment. It is a fascinating and, you know, a pretty controversial economic trade-off. And that, of course, brings us to our final and really crucial question. See, this whole process, it hinges on one thing. Workers' wages not keeping up with prices. But let's be real. People aren't going to accept a real pay cut forever, right? Eventually, they're going to demand raises to catch up. So while this totally explains the short-term link between inflation and jobs, the really big question remains, can this trade-off actually last? And that's a debate that sits right at the very heart of economic policy. Thanks for joining us.